Thank you, thank you. This is still Stand Up and Bite Me. My name is Jason Blanchard, and we're halfway through the show. Just a reminder for those of you at home, you can go online right now and vote for your favorite comedian. You just have to go to bite.ca/standup, pick the comic you like the best, and vote for them. That's right. Send them all the way to Toronto so they have a chance to win $10,000. Your next comedian coming to the stage, born in Winnipeg, Manitoba, living in Winnipeg, Manitoba, please welcome Kevin Dobbie.
Hi, I'm Kevin Dobbie, from Winnipeg, still from Winnipeg, and I like cheese. I guess the first time I wanted to get into stand-up comedy was when I saw my first comedy special when I was about 10, which was Sam Kinison, and I liked the idea that he got to say whatever he wanted and scream a whole lot. I've been doing stand-up comedy for 5 years. I would describe my stand-up style as stream of consciousness. I just kind of say whatever comes to mind. I get inspiration for material from my daily life and just general type things that happen while I'm out and about. Well, the after the show routine is the same if it's a good or bad show. It's some sort of hamburger with iced tea. If I win the $10,000, I'm probably gonna eat a whole lot of pizza and die sad and alone. You'll read about it in the paper, it's gonna be awesome. My strategy to get people to vote for me is hopefully to tell funny jokes tonight so that when they watch my video, they'll have a good laugh and then they'll feel like voting for me.
That's right. We look the same as you. That's right, my toes aren't even webbed. You thought they would be. Surprisingly, though, my parents are cousins. That's real. I'm just kidding. So I landed yesterday in Vancouver. It was exciting, and I had to go buy weed. See, and you thought you didn't like me because I was from Winnipeg. Friend, we could go smoke one right after this. We could all be friends here. It's cool. We'll have some nachos. It's good. But once when I was high, I was in the car with a buddy of mine, and we had the tape recorder going because it was the 90s, son. It was a long time ago. Don't worry, it's cool. You probably don't even know what Thundercats is. It's fine. So we're recording our conversations in the car as we're high, and this comes on. My buddy going, dude. And you've heard this. You're like, dude. You see that license plate in front of us? And I was like, yeah. It means that guy's blind. We were at a fucking red light. I looked at him and I was like, dude, blind guys can't drive. He's like, no, whoa, stay with me. Means he's only a little bit blind. Am I the only one who thinks a little bit's too fucking much? I want to see this guy's car with the little white stick going tick, 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 thud.
What the
fuck was that? And also, I used to love getting super baked with one buddy, and he lives in Coquitlam now. Coquitlam in the house? All right. Yeah. Anyway, so we ordered Chinese food, right? And I order an $800 order of Chinese food for two people. Now, the guy on the end of the phone must have been some kind of wizard or something, because he figured out that I wasn't having a family picnic for $700 at 2 in the morning. So he comes through and goes, how many people you order for? And I was like, two. No. What? No. Okay. It's too much food. Okay. I used to be 400 pounds. I'm slim down. Slim. 290 right now. You're loving it, right? You're loving it. Good stuff. Weight loss. Yeah. Anyway, I found out this never happens at Burger King because apparently Burger King is the equivalent of a slutty drunk girl at a party. Oh, that's right, friends. No matter what time of night, you're getting some. And it's gonna be sloppy. I just ruined sluts and Burger King for at least 10 of you. And I apologize. And after I went to Burger King and had one of my little let's eat 8 Whoppers and see if I can still be alive tomorrow moments, one of my girlfriends was like, let's go horseback riding. And I was like, okay. So I went, and I'm horseback riding. They get me up on this horse. And number one, when you're 400 pounds, you don't want to get up that high. Right. I don't want to tell you this, but you look like you bounce. You don't. Oh, sweet Jesus, how you do not bounce. So they get me on this horse and it starts going poof, 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 and doing this. I was like, great, this horse is gonna go lightning fast. And then I heard the guy go, could somebody go to the barn and get Hercules and get this guy down? Apparently, for those of you that don't speak horse, means get the hell off me, fat ass. I'm not a Buick. I can't take that, seriously. That's right, and I have a joke here about texting. Anybody love texting? How about you, friend? Do you love it? No? Do you like anything? Are you that guy from the front row that doesn't like shit that they're talking about? Well, here's my new text signs. I wrote them down because they're hard and confusing because I smoked some of that Vancouver weed. And the reason I wrote these is because there was a girl in one of my university classes who used to vocally text. So she'd be like, BRB. When the fuck did we start doing that with words? Isn't that the reason we invented texting, to shorten words? But here's my list of texts for her, and I really wanted to fuck her badly. And the text messages that I've invented will represent that. The first one is IHOP, and it's not pancakes, friend. You were thinking about it, but it's not. It's I hope you're on the pill. Right. Get ready, these get better. There's one that says ISTNH, which means, anybody? Anybody? Okay, this might not have happened. It's, I'm sorry, this never happens. You can also add TM on that one for to me. Then there's one that says, I have herpes, IHH. I know. You can get it from a toilet seat, I swear. I got it from a whore, but you can get it from a toilet seat. I checked, and it's the story I tell every girl I get with. Wasn't whores. And the last one after I have herpes is just, I'm sorry, IS. I know, isn't it terrible? And the last thing I'm going to talk about is dirty talk. Guys who thinks they're good at it. Take a look, ladies, none of us, because we don't know. Every girl comes with the same standard line. I'm wet. Gotta tell? Thanks, I'm Kevin. Thank you, guys. You've been great.
Kevin Dobbie!
I feel like it went pretty well. Very friendly crowd. I've been here before. Love Laugh Lines. It's a great club. I feel pretty good about it. I liked it. I enjoyed it. I had a good time. Everybody, even if I, you know, if nothing positive comes of this, other than hanging out with all the comedians and whatnot, it's been a big win because it's been a great, great experience. People out here really seem to like jokes that involve sex and weed. And I like sex and weed. So those two things seem to work for me. Try not to focus on the bad. I focus on the good, you know, always moving forward. Well, see, that guy from Vancouver was all, ooh, boo, Winnipeg sucks. So I had to warm him up and be like, hey, buddy, I like weed, too. I can tell you're a stoner, you bearded, dreadlock little weird guy. That's right, dude. You're not here. I can say whatever I want. Weird ginger with dreadlocks and a weird freaky beard. Deal with it. Deal with it. What's that about? What's that? We're not friends.